Hello YouTube.
It is a pretty Sunday evening in Louisiana. This is a Louisiana lifestyle. Like I said before, I am new to YouTube, so like and subscribe. The more stuff, the more subscribers and likes I get, the more content I can put out. Yeah. All right, well, this is a 2020 Polaris Sportsman 850. I said on a previous video that I would do a video when I put my 30s on. So we're gonna take a look at everything on this. We're gonna look at the ground clearance and the fitment. So I got my tape measure and I'm gonna show you. As I turn the wheel, it's not even close. I mean, yeah, it ain't rubbing, it ain't even close to rubbing. You can put a big, the front is no issues whatsoever. Now come back to the back here. Now we got a little bit, we got probably maybe an inch or so of clearance right here. So that's pretty close there, but right here, if you know anything about these sportsmen putting like the Outlaws and stuff, they'll rub right here. Well, it ain't even close, right? I mean, so I'm not gonna have an issue. It has to do with the specific wheel and tire combination. This is not a very deep offset wheel. It's got a lot more in the back. It's not very deep offset. It's a ITP SS wheel. And this is a 30x9 Zila. They're skinnies all the way around. So the wheel and tire combination fits almost perfect for this sportsman. And we measured this a while ago. It's about an inch and a half on the center, and it's a little bit more than that on the side. So it doesn't have that big lug like the Outlaw, so it won't. That's usually what breaks your axle whenever you have problems with the original Outlaw. Outlaw 2s aren't as bad, but I like these tires. They're a little safer when it comes to breaking axles, but they're plenty aggressive, as you can see. So we're gonna get some measurements on the front and rear. I did a video on what it was before, on what the ground clearance was after I turned the shocks up all the way. So there were 30 inch by 9s. There was with the shocks turned up all the way. Stock, no lift, just stock. All right, that's about 17 and 8 height. Before it was 15 and 8, so we got 2 inches of extra ground clearance on the front. Now let's check the back. On the back, before I believe it was 12 and 3/4. It was a good bit less on the back. We had like 2 inches higher in the front and the back, but then now it's showing 15 and a quarter. And it was 12 and 3/4, so that is an inch, 2.5 inches higher in the back. So lifted 2.5 inches higher in the back, and 2 in the front. So it was 17 and 1/8 in the front, 15 and 1/4 in the back of that. That is up there. That's a lot of ground clearance. Of course, stock bike, no lift, no nothing, just the shocks turned up. This is a Sportsman 850, and I honestly, I wouldn't, unless you're going with something killer with the axle that shifts down to give you more ground clearance, you really don't really need much more than that. I don't want anything more than that. You might get a snorkel or something if you're going to go through a lot of water. But also, you know, my belt box has not leaked yet. I've been through, my belt box is back here. It has not leaked yet. It's not leaked yet. So I'm pretty sure I can go, and I put it through water to about here. So, and that's above the belt box, and your intake is up here. So if you wanna see how much water that actually, how high I can actually go, So that would probably, that would be 3 inches, 3 foot of water. I can go in 3 foot of water right now without it, without, you know, getting even close to my, and that's right here. So that 3 foot is here. So 3 foot of water is, it's pretty, it's waist deep, you know, so that's pretty good. These are the ones that I took off. They're 26 inch on 14 wheels. We are actually going to go ahead and swap them and put them on the 450. The 450 has 24s on it right now, which I don't really know why I did that. We did a video on it before, but the one thing I like is we got one tire over here to show you the difference between the tires that are on it and the tires that were on my bike. That's a, and what the difference is in the height. It, you see how much bigger this tire is than this. I believe it'll fit a 28, so we're gonna get some 28 inch Zillas for it. But we're talking almost a 3 inch difference between that tire and this tire with the rim and the tire. It, you know, every tire measures differently. But we're gonna put them on the 450 and give him some ground clearance. I'm gonna show you the maximum sag. This thing is impressive with a 24 inch tire. Look at the ground clearance on this thing, on the back. It's almost 14 inches of ground clearance on the back of this 450 with a 24 inch tire. So this thing is impressive when it comes to ground clearance. It actually, I believe with the 26s, it'll probably have more ground clearance than my bike on the back. Now on the front, no. Well, you see the front of this thing, you get down low, a 17 and an 8 of ground clearance. I mean, that's more than the 5 gallon, way more than 5 gallon bucket. I mean, it's a lot of ground clearance. But that's a mean looking beast, and with no lift, no nothing, so you ain't putting your axles too much in a bind. 30s. The way that I have it set up fit with no issues whatsoever. So it's a pretty thick tire, so puncture resistant. The 30s will fit. You just gotta get the right combination without even rubbing at all. So I just wanted to check it out. I want like and subscribe, and we're gonna do the 450 swap out next. So thanks for watching and have a good one.